whoop her.
Amen.
He ain't gonna be no pain. Ain't nobody gonna hurt.
That's right.
You gonna see all you love once you lost.
Amen.
I just want to thank God for coming by.
Amen. Amen.
Was no longer redemption, deep inside, you know he's living, and death has died. If you're wandering in the darkness, come and step into the light.
Amen. going into a lion's den or a fiery furnace or something like that. We've been praying. They be food today, I'm telling you. But the fact of the matter is, what kind of prayer service would we have going on if we thought we'd been thrown into a fire that's seven times hotter than anything on this earth? Or if we'd been fixing meat by a big old lion? I'm telling you, I'm going to get myself right now. I mean, and I'd be praying. That's what we should walk in here and do every Sunday, because there's somebody dying and going to hell. In every congregation, in every church this morning, there are people that are dying and going to hell, and we don't care. We don't have enough gumption about ourselves to even pray for them. That is just sad. I'm putting myself in there, too. I ain't talking about nobody but myself.
That's right.
But the fact of the matter is, you know, we need to look at them like they're in a burning car, and we can't get them out. But we can get them out if we just pray hard enough.
Yeah,
and I just don't see a lot of concern going on about it in this day and time. And not only them, but honestly, we need to get ourselves right. Because if we ain't where we can pray for them, we ain't a bit good to God. We might as well just sit on a pew just, or sit at the house on the couch and watch TV, watch Joel Osteen on TV, because that's about how good we are. That's about the good we are doing in this world today. For our teenagers, for our elderly, for our middle aged. It's not. We shouldn't just be concerned about the 4 and 5 year olds. We need to be concerned from 45 to 95. They all dying and going to hell, and we ain't got a bit of concern about it. We see it sitting right in here in this church this morning. We have got to get to a place where we can pray for people. And I'm talking about myself. Don't think I'm judging nobody else. Because I'm not. But myself and I need to get to a place where I can pray for people and have it. And you know, if I thought this week, there's a lot of people sitting in our congregation. And if we was where we would need to be,
they couldn't sit there.
Because I remember being in those hot places where the preacher come down and the service was going, and I thought, oh, Lord, he's talking right to me. And the day I got saved, I felt like Brother Ronnie Gary was right in my face, and his finger was pointing in my eyeball. Because I was that guilty. I couldn't look him in the eye. But that guilt is gone nowadays, because it's just let's come in, let's get this over with, let's go home, let's do whatever we're going to do. But we need to dedicate this time, whatever time we're in this church house, whatever time we're walking these streets out here, because God says go to the highways and byways. And we need to be telling people about the Lord. But we need to get ourselves where we can tell the people about the Lord, honestly.
Amen. I don't know about y'all, but our Sunday school class this morning, we just went completely different than what we normally do. We've been normally studying in Acts, but God just laid on my heart when we studied about prayer and our prayer life with God and that relationship with God. So many people think that when they get saved, that's all that happens. That's it. You know, I've got to accomplish what it is God wants, but no, that's just the beginning of your spiritual life with Jesus Christ. And if you ain't moving forward in your relationship with Him, then you're moving backwards in your relationship with Him. If you're not moving forward to Jesus and God's work and His plan in your life, then you're working for self and Satan over here in the world somewhere. We've got the worldly concerns on our minds. We got the worldly pleasures on our minds. We got all this other stuff out here. Like I said before, we're looking around us to see what in the world is going on. We need to be looking above us and saying, God, you direct. You direct what needs to be going on. You grab a hold of me and strengthen that relationship. We were talking about David this morning and how he was put up against that Goliath, that giant over there, and how he wasn't looking with old fleshly eyes. Now, if I was looking with old fleshly eyes at a giant that stood about half my, 2 times my size there, I'd be thinking, oh God, what have I got myself into? But he wasn't thinking like that, no. He was thinking spiritually. He said, my God, that I'm stronger than this, that I'm greater than you. You can come to me with your armor. You can come with me with your sword. You can come with me with all this valiant stuff about you, but you ain't going to defeat my God. And because of that, I'll come to you, not with armor, not with a sword, but with my little old slingshot right here. And I'm going to come after you because I know my God is victorious in me. My God will supply victory over you. My God. I wonder how many of us would face a giant today and be able to stand that firm on their walk with God, be able to stand that firm on their relationship with God, that God would deliver them against an old giant today. I would have to say with me, just like those Israelite people over there, that whole entire army, waving that old white flag over there saying, I can't do it. I can't do it. Look at that big old man there. That entire army was looking with their old physical eyes. They weren't connected with Jesus Christ. The church today ain't connected with Jesus Christ. No, we ain't connected with Jesus the way we need to be. We let Satan defeat us, and we're looking at it with these old physical eyes saying, no, he's too big for me. He's too big for me. I serve a bigger God than that. I serve a bigger God than that. I ask you either to get in on the army or get out completely. Don't hinder the rest of us from having church. Amen. Get connected right here. Plug into the source. You can't have no power running through you unless you're plugged into the vine. You can't bear no fruit unless you're plugged into the vine. You ain't nothing but a branch, and a branch without a vine will wither and die because it has no source of power. It has no source of food. It has no source of nutrients. We got too many Christians that are just branches laying around on the ground somewhere because they ain't connected to the vine. That old fruit that you're supposed to be bearing for God is all withered up and they become raisin sour to the taste. I can't even stand them. Now that's not y'all I'm talking about. I'm talking about them raisins. I don't like them. But it's because they've already been cut off from the vine. They've already been cut off from the vine and they withered up. They shrunk up and they got an old nasty taste to them. I want a good old ripe grape. I want a grape that's ready, that's connected to the vine, that I go right up to the vine. Grandma used to have an old vine out there behind the house. And I'd walk up to that vine and say, oh man. She'd say, honey, wait just a minute. They ain't ripe yet. They ain't ripe yet, but that day they're ripe. I'd walk out there. I'd say, oh Lord, this is so good. I'd grab a couple of them grapes off the vine and just pop them in. Pop them in. Because they were connected to the vine. They were connected to the vine, to the source. How many of us are bearing grapes in our lives? How many of us are bearing fruit in our lives? I would dare to say we got a bunch of raisins hanging down around in here. Amen. Get connected with Jesus Christ. Get connected. Get plugged into the power source. Get plugged in. When you get plugged in, you'll start seeing things change in life a little bit. When you get plugged in, you'll start seeing outcomes in your life situation start changing a little bit. You'll be looking through those spiritual eyes saying, God, it may look that I'm defeated. It may look that I'm defeated with these old fleshly eyes. But God, with these spiritual eyes, I'm looking through what you're seeing. And you're going to bring me out on the other side. You're going to bring me out on the other side. Get plugged into the vine. Get plugged into Jesus.
That's right.
The only way you're going to do that is if you get connected with Him through prayer. Amen. You got to have that old prayer life. If you ain't got that old prayer life, we talked about that this morning. If that old prayer line is all webbed up and cobbed up and everything, then what's your connection to Jesus? You ain't got one. You ain't got one. If you can't do nothing in this world, if your old physical body says, hey, you can't walk another mile, if your old physical body says, hey, you can't stand up anymore, if your old physical body says, hey, you can't speak anymore, if your old physical body says, hey, you can't see no more, I'll tell you what you can do for Jesus Christ, that you can pray. You got a prayer line with Him. You ain't got to be able to do nothing with this right here in order to pray to Jesus Christ.
Yeah, amen.
Amen. That's a spiritual. That's a spiritual thing there. That prayer line with God. That's why our youth today, only 4% believe that there's a Jesus Christ. They only 4% believe that there's a heaven that's going to be gained by those that are saved and a hell that's going to be gained by those that are lost. It's not their fault. It's my fault and your fault because we stopped praying. We stopped connecting with Jesus Christ. We're these branches over here that are withered up. We've lost our sweetness. We've lost our power. We've lost our ability to bear fruit because we ain't connected to the vine. We ain't connected to the vine. Tell you what, I just knew revival was going to continue on. When we went into revival, I thought, okay, God, you're fixing to do a mighty work here. You're going to do something great here. But then once we got closer to the end of the week, it just seemed like Brother Roy said, it seemed like God said, whatever's supposed to be accomplished is accomplished. Now, I'm not saying that God couldn't accomplish more, but when His people have unplugged from the vine, what more could He accomplish? Amen. Wednesday night, it was the biggest crowd we had all week, which surprised me because Wednesday night, people usually go to their own churches. Biggest night we had all week, we get here Thursday night, we had maybe 20. Where's everybody at? You ain't plugging into the Lord. You ain't plugging into God. Power source right here. Come get plugged in if you ain't got it right with the Lord. Get it right here. Get it right here. This revival could have went on for 2 years if we would have got ourselves right with God. This revival could have went on until He come back if we would have got ourselves right with God and got plugged up to the power source. But too many of us have said, oh God, you've been doing this long. God, good this far, I'm just gonna go ahead and unplug and write off of what I got. Write off of what I got. That ain't gonna work. That old grapevine, when that branch is cut off that vine, those grapes for the next few days still look like grapes, right? They still look like grapes and probably good and fresh and juicy, but you give them a week or two and they'll begin to get all nasty and shrivel up. It's because they ain't connected to the vine. Too many of God's soldiers, too many of God's soldiers aren't connected to the vine, and y'all just shriveled up on me. You look like you've been swimming for 42 days. Your body's all wrinkled up. You ain't connected to the power source. You got to get connected. You got to get connected. When there's a seriousness come about God's people that are tired of seeing the world traveling the way that it's going in, and when you see the people around you traveling in the way that it's going in, when you decide yourself to get plugged up with God, then you can be a change in this old world. But until then, you can't be a change to this old world. How can you be a change if you ain't plugged up to the one that can change you? Amen. This old altar right here, I see many stains on it, but I fear that these old stains may not be as many needs to be down here on it. You need to be down here praying for your family. You need to be down here praying for those lost co-workers. You need to be down here praying for yourself, praying that you have a direct line of communication with God, that you're ready, to be a soldier working for God, and not some raisin over here to the side. Not some branch that is no longer connected to the vine. That they may all be gathered up and threw into a fire somewhere. If you ain't where you need to be with God this morning, just because revival ended Friday night doesn't mean it can't pick back up today.
Amen.
There should always be revival right here. Whether we're meeting as a church, whether we're meeting as a community, whether we're meeting as a group of people, revival should always be going on right here in self. And if it's not, you need to be seeking it. You need to be seeing what's in your way. What sin wedge is being driven between you and God that needs to be uprooted and moved out of the way. Uprooted and moved out of the way so that you can be in a direct line of connection with Jesus Christ. Amen. I don't know what to say. Maybe you have to.
Thank you.
was home when the doctor shook his head and said, she's gone. You could feel the mother's heartbreak. You could hear them crying. Their little girl was only 12 years old.
You just take one more step for God. When you think that life has just let you down, just pray a little harder. Just pray a little harder and get in touch with God. Because as Mandy sang there a while ago, it is power in prayer.
Amen.
That's the power that you and I have. That's the tool that you and I have to fight Satan and the rules of darkness of this world. That's what we have, is the power of prayer. That connecting line that we have to the Lord Jesus this morning. That's why we possess, those of us that are born again of the Holy Spirit of God. Those of us that are saved. Because the Bible tells us that one day that New Jerusalem is going to ascend down. God's people is going there. And God himself is going to be with his people. And won't that be something, us being in the presence of God forever and forever? That'll be something else for us to see. Where he's going to take away every teardrop. Going to take away every pain, every disease, every sorrow. He's going to take everything away. And we're going to live in total happiness and total peace for all eternity. When you can't go on, just take another step. When you can't go on, just bow a little lower and call out to God. He said, I'll never leave you and I'll never forsake you. I'll always be with you. But if you're here and if you've never accepted Jesus, if you've never called upon him to be your Lord and your Savior, let me encourage you to do that today. Time's running out. In the book of Revelation chapter 16, it tells us there, and it outlines every kind of walk of man. From the richest to the poorest to the leaders to the kings to everybody. And when that wrath of God falls, that they're going to be crying and begging for the rocks to fall on them.
That's right.
And cover them up, but it's not going to happen. You say they'll be begging to die and can't because of the wrath of God. You don't have to die spiritually. We're going to die in this old body. We're going to die in this old body. But when this old body takes that last breath and that last heartbeat, then we'll make that crossing. We're going to go out into eternity.
Amen.
And it's going to be forevermore.
Amen.
Now the question is, where are you going to spend it? It's two ways. It ain't 3, 4, 9, or 11. It's two ways. It's a heaven and it's a hell. If you make the choice where you stand, stand with me this morning, if you will, please. As we begin to sing this song, you've got a need for Jesus. Get it on this altar. Get around this altar and let God take care of it, because you can't handle it. You can't take care of it. But let God do it. Let him take care of every situation that you've got. We've all got situations. We've all got pains. It's heartbreaking. We've got a situation in our family that's heartbreaking to us. But you see, it ain't a thing we do about it but pray. And pray and lift it up to God. Let God take care of it. And it'll be the same thing in your life and in your situations that you're going through. You can't handle them, but I can point you to a man that can.
Amen.
And I can point you to a man that'll save your soul and put you on the road to glory land. And his name is Jesus. You come as the Lord leads us. We begin to sing right now. Wherever you are, you come on. You come on. Come on, wherever you might be. You've got a need. Bring it this altar. Lay it on. Let you down this morning. He'll meet you when you take that one step. He'll meet you right there. He'll change you forevermore. Well, I tell you, it's nothing like being on that road to glory this morning. It's nothing like being saved. It's nothing like knowing Jesus as your personal Lord and Savior. There's not anything like it. I beg you, if you're here and if you're that sheep this morning and you don't know Him and you just know about Him, come and get to know Him. Come and get to know Him on a personal basis this morning. Come and let Him change you. Come and let Him make a new creature out of you this morning. I tell you, we just got to stay with God this morning. Whatever comes or whatever happens, we've just got to stay with God. We've just got to stay with Him. The Bible tells me in the book of Matthew, I think it's chapter 26, about verse 56, that when things got hard, and when Jesus had been arrested, when He was betrayed and all that, it tells me there that even His very disciples forsook Him. They turned their back upon Him and walked away. Don't you turn your back upon Him this morning. Don't you turn your back upon Him and walk out of this church today. Don't you turn your back on Him, lost and undone, on your way to hell, walk out that door this morning. Don't you do it when it's so easy to take one step for Jesus in that faith, and He'll change you forever there. He'll change you forevermore. day. I can make you come all day if you're not going to hunt and ain't going. That's between you and Jesus. I've done all I know to do. Between Stacy and Ryan and Bunch together there, I made me a few notes for the sermon there today and I've got it down. A little thing or two, what I wanted to say, and I hit on every one of them so it wasn't on there, me going nowhere. They done it for me today. Amen.